Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, we had a question on one of our e-commerce videos, and they were saying they wanted to add a PayPal smart button like we've got here to their site, but it doesn't show up. You sometimes get that on the back end when you add the little code module, but you usually find on the front end it shows up absolutely perfectly. And I'll demonstrate this. So to do this, go over to your PayPal and create a smart button. For anybody that doesn't know how to do this, log into your PayPal. Go to Pay and Get Paid. And down here, you'll find PayPal buttons. I'll bring you to this page right here. And they've got some great buttons for selling on social, buy now, multiple products, donations, subscribe, etc. And here's the smart buttons on the left hand side. Simply click on it. You can choose to have a fixed price, single selects list, or a variable price. I'm going to do a fixed price. I'm going to say as that's what we've got in there. Item price, let's make it $10. Obviously, if you're not in the US, choose your currency here. If you want to add a shipping fee, put it in there. And if you want to calculate tax, put that in there too. I'm going to keep this simple and just make it simple $10. And it's going to look like this. I'm not signed up for Venmo, so I won't have that button there. Now you can style your button here. Defaults to vertical, I quite like that. You can have it horizontal, rectangle, pill-shaped. Pill-shaped just means it's got round corners. I put it on there. That's pill shaped right there. In fact, that's for fun, we'll just leave it like that. You can choose your colors. And again, I'm happy for that to be like that. Button text, you can have PayPal, checkout, buy now, or pay. PayPal, I quite like it to say that purely because it's so trusted. When you're happy with your styling and everything that's gone on there, let's copy the code. Okay, now the code's copied to your clipboard. If you want to know what it looks like, it's a pretty simple bit of HTML with a bit of script here. That's what it looks like, but you really don't need to worry about that. You might want to paste it into a text file or something in case you accidentally copy something else in between this and creating your module. So let's go to our page. I'm going to enable the visual builder. I'll just get rid of this and we'll do it again. And as you can see on the back end, it's kind of disappeared, it's not there. And this is what the guy was asking in his question. I think he thought that it wasn't going to work because it wasn't here on the back end. And quite often with WooCommerce buttons and various scripts, when you put them in, when the builders engage like this, you won't see them. And for confusion purposes, or to stop confusion, what I like to do with things like this, if you can't see them, is go to the back end, hit the little purple button, and we'll edit in the wireframe mode so that you can see. I just got a code module there. Let's get rid of that. That's the buttons gone. That's just the little article at the top there. So we're just left with this now. Okay, well, let's go back in the wireframe. We'll add another code module. There we are. You can probably do this with a text module. Well, let's try it. But you want to make sure you're in text mode, not visual. Here's visual, here's text. Let's just try this in text. The one you were looking at earlier was a code module. Okay, so we've put that in there. Now let's save this. And go back to front end mode or desktop mode. Still can't see it. Let's save our draft. And exit the visual builder. Yeah, obviously it doesn't work in the text module, so let's get back in there and do it in the code module like I did it before. Okay, and I'm gonna go back into my wireframe. I'm gonna get rid of that text module. And let's go down and put a code module in. There we go. And what we're gonna do is simply paste our text back in there again. There it is. We'll save this. And like any other Divi module, you can style it and do what you want with it. I'm going to leave mine absolutely plain. Go back in. Again, we can't see it, but let's save the draft and exit this time, and it should show up. There we go. I forgot we did the pill shape, didn't we? There we go. There's our PayPal smart button. And they can pay with debit, credit cards, pay PayPal later, regular PayPal. And it's got the powered by PayPal down here for trust. So there you go. I hope that's answered your question. Like I say, if it doesn't show on the back end, just check it on the front end, and it should be there using the code module. So I hope that's answered your question, and I hope you've enjoyed this today. If you found it useful, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.